There is a world to enjoy, traverse, circumnavigate.
Let us do this.
I always thought that we should build a world according to Bella and to her understanding and perception of it.
We're in Budapest, in Hungary, shooting on many sound stages. Our world has been built. It's been unbelievable.
I could never figure out someone specific. I thought that maybe if I put two people that have, you know, very different minds together, and if it worked out and if they got along, it would become something very interesting.
We all share as collaborators a admiration for Yorgos's work and absolute love of the script.
I have adventured it and found nothing but sugar and violence. It is most charming.
It felt sort of timeless. Your mind just starts racing of where it could go. London, Lisbon, Paris. We've built a composite set, epic in scale. Yorgos wanted a 1930s film, but with today's technology.
They worked very closely in tandem, and I remember seeing the early lookbooks of what they were working on, because they have two very different sensibilities that seem to have met up so beautifully.
I mean, you could see they've created a world. It's Victorian, it's a dream, it's gorgeous, and it really does serve the vision.
It really defines the story we're telling. It's got a refined aesthetic, but it's also got a sense of humor. I got scared for a second. I thought we were trapped in here.
There's so much originality. There are fish on Bella's ceiling, and there's seaweed and a mirror that has ears and these padded silk walls with cityscapes sewn in. And I want to copy it. I want to live in that bedroom.
The functioning shops, the doors lead to actual rooms. It's incredible. I do think that there's a spiritual connection that happens.
You don't have to make anything up. Everything's there. Everything that you need is there. And then there's more. It feels like something of the era, but also it has so many nods to the future.
We use the latest technology, but also tapped into some old school techniques like miniatures or painted backdrops. And I think it was an interesting combination of techniques.
And it is as big as it looks, even in a 4mm lens, which is the widest possible angle. It's bigger than that. I've never seen anything like it.